recently. That was pretty bad. That was bad. Going back and forth like that. It's hard when you're looking at a camera. And it's the complete opposite of etching. What it feels like. But anyhow, I'm in this day three. I didn't get a chance to go out yesterday the second. Basically, I was pretty sick the second. And I just didn't want to get up in the morning. I had to work that night. And I just freaking did not feel like going in the morning. I was too dead tired. And, the paint is TamoFX paint. I'm not sponsored by them in any way. But, this paint's awesome. It is just, it's no mess. It's just like that. And you turn the wheel and it comes off just like that. And it's awesome. It's really easy to come off your face, too. We're actually at a different spot today. We're at my second spot. Let's put this on a little bit more. Basically, the second spot is I usually move to this spot a lot later in the season. We're talking like November 1st. It's usually when I'm back up in here. I never hunt this spot this early. For the simple fact that the deer really aren't here. They pile up here a lot during the, towards winter. Like, you know, our winter starts like December 1st. Usually when they start piling up in here, like from November 1st to December 1st, they're all in here. They all seem to be in here. And this is a very, very, very hot doe bedding area. There's a lot of does that bed up in this area too. And towards the middle of November, right around the first 2 weeks of November, I started getting a lot of bucks on camera. That I know they're only in here for the sole purpose of trying to find a hot doe. And so basically that's why I hunt this spot a lot later in the season, especially when the does really start to get into the rut or they start going into heat. They pile up in here along with all the other does and whatnot. But it's still been windy, been crazy windy. Yeah, it's just really small. But yeah, it's like trying to wait for the right time for the wind to stop doing anything, to stop blowing. So it's just been bad, real bad with the wind. But, hopefully tonight we can see something. I can get something on film, at least. But, we'll see how it goes tonight. I still haven't even pulled my bow up yet. Basically, I don't have a rope for this tree to pull my straw back to pull my bow up. And I was rushing out to my staff, forgot to say this, and completely forgot a rope. So luckily, I had this rope in there. It's pretty thin, but it's white. That's my problem. That is white rope. What is white signal for deer, for especially the white deer? You know, yeah. It's not good. It's in this danger, so I don't know, I might just spray paint it and use it. We'll see. But for the time being, it's what I have to wear for today at least. So, and you know, I've got to go and put my bow up, back lip, and sit tight for a couple hours at least, till sun comes in, which I hope is pretty soon. Probably just a bird. So you hear that one movement though, it's sick. Thank you. I couldn't tell you. But it's that sounded like a deer, it wasn't. But yeah, I basically am hoping that this spot's gonna be good. I know a lot of times that this is an area that the deer use later in the season, especially when there's snow, like in December. Is it just a corn trail over there? I'm sitting about 80 or so yards away from the corn edge. And when that corn's done, there's snow. And after they've retilled the ground up, the deer seem to come through here and go out to the corn. And they do that all over. There's different joke points on this property that the deer come out of. And this is kind of one of them. This area back up in here, especially if you get a little bit farther back up in the hardwoods, the buck activity really picks up. They seem to stick around back up in there. And there's tons of scrapes, just tons of scrapes up in there. And that's all that's here on this side, is tons of scrapes. There's no buck rubs, but there is a ton of buck rubs later in the rut. This is not the rut right now, it's way early in the season. Except back over that way, there's a literally to be able to get loaded with rubs. There's a rub line that's been there for that bunch of years since I've been on here, probably the past 4 or 5 years. They've been using the same run. See, rub line through and through and through over and over and over again. And I put the camera up on it and never got a single picture of a buck. I put one right on a rub and I only got like 3 does on it, and that was it. But yeah, basically about the spot, the pond's right over there. The swamp is back up that way, pretty much off, right off to my 11 o'clock, 10, 11 o'clock. And it's swamp back that way too, off my 9 o'clock. And by swamp, I mean thick pine. Really, really thick pine that the deer bed down in. So, I'm hoping tonight, we'll see, it's only day 5, it's still early in the season, that maybe a doe will come bebopping through and head into the field. But we'll see. Also, I'll put my arrows in the quiver, and I put one in there and it snapped on me. It literally broke right in half. And thankfully I have some spares, but now I gotta get 3 more arrows made, so I'm down to, I think, 3 or 4. And I always like to go out with at least 6, but I never put 2 in my quiver at a time, 2 or 3 in my quiver, and that's it. That's all I put in it. Okay, I probably should fill it up, but 2 to 3 is perfect for me. But basically, we'll see what happens. Spot might have just become a bust. Couple Friday, I had him back where my other stand. The stand used to be back there on the back side of the pond. I moved the camera to the back side of the pond and pushed it down up in the mud. I found a good sized tree. I was able to push it in the mud. There's a camera that way. might have just become a bust. Because if there's a predator like that in the area, the deer are going to come through. Because I noticed that the red squirrels are going nuts right now. Thank you. See a deer. is into the season.